others. Tonight in Medical Rounds, while malignant melanoma of the eye is rare, precursors of this disease are quite common. In fact, 1 in 10 Caucasians will develop a mole under the retina during their lifetime. While many moles in the eye are benign and very low risk, some do have higher risk characteristics and could transform into a true melanoma. Joining us live now from Hartford Hospital is Dr. Scott Walter. Dr. Walter is one of only 2 ocular oncologists practicing in Connecticut and is the only physician trained as a retinal surgeon. Good evening, Dr. Walter. Thanks for being with us tonight.
Thanks, Denise. It's great to be here.
Well, let us talk about this ocular melanoma. This is, I have to tell you, this is the first time I'm hearing about it. Tell us about it.
Well, ocular melanoma, believe it or not, is actually the most common cancer that originates within the eye, although many cancers can spread from other parts of the body to the eye.
How rare is it?
Well, ocular melanoma is quite rare, about 30 to 40 times less common than skin melanoma. However, just in the state of Connecticut alone, there's about 25 to 30 cases per year. I just started practice here 4 months ago, and I've already diagnosed and treated 8 patients with this condition. So we're now on track to see most of the patients within the state of Connecticut.
Wow.
I'm also seeing a lot of patients from central Connecticut who were previously treated out of state. So it's great that we now have treatment options here in state.
That is good to hear. And I have to ask about the symptoms. Is this something you could see yourself if you're looking in the mirror? If you see a dark spot, maybe in the white, the sclera part of the eye, would that be something you need to get checked? What are the symptoms?
Well, about 10% of eye melanomas originate near the front of the eye where they may be visible, but the majority of them originate in the back of the eye, and oftentimes patients are completely asymptomatic. So it could be something that's picked up on a routine eye exam when your eyes are dilated or photos are taken of the back of the eye. And really only when these tumors become larger and cause secondary complications like a retinal detachment do they cause symptoms like loss of central or peripheral vision, floaters, flashes, or other symptoms.
Good to keep in mind. You made a lot of people aware of this tonight, including myself, and we thank you so much, Dr. Walter, for the great information. And if you are interested in learning more about ocular melanoma or the Hartford Healthcare Cancer Institute's Melanoma and Skin Cancer Center, call the number you see on the screen. In the meantime, Dr. Walter is available to answer your questions at a live Facebook discussion on the Hartford Hospital Facebook page beginning in just a few minutes at 6 o'clock.